Welcome to the introduction to the computational chemistry playlist. Computational chemistry can be broadly defined as the use of computers to solve the equations of a theory or model for the properties of chemical systems, or shall we say, for the prediction of the properties of chemical systems. So traditionally, science had two main branches. We had theory and experiment, where theory made certain predictions for experiment, and experiment tested those predictions and refined the theory. When I use the term model up here inside of theory or model, by model I just mean a simplified representation of a physical system. Sometimes when you're talking about theory, you're talking about something much more broadly applicable and something much more general. And sometimes when we're talking about a model, we're talking about something more simplified and more specific to certain kinds of systems. But sometimes the terms are used interchangeably, and so you have to just look at the context of the discussion to see whether or not theory and model mean the same thing. Okay, so we had our traditional situation here with theory and experiment, but due to the advent of modern computers, computers are now capable of performing arithmetic so quickly that we have what's essentially another branch of science emerging up here called simulation. So now with theory, we can generate mathematical equations which are very complicated and require a lot of intense computing, but simulation can find solutions to those theories or to those models. And similarly, if something would be a very difficult experiment to perform, we can perform a simulation which can help with the interpretation of that experiment and its refining and testing of hypotheses. And experiment can further develop new parameters that can go back into improving the simulation and its feedback to experiment. So these three branches of science are all feedback loops into one another, with simulation being the newest member of the three. Okay, so as I mentioned, simulation is the newest member. That's because computing did not become widely popular until the second half of the 20th century. And that is because computing is now much faster than it has ever been before. So why is computing so much faster now? Well, things we have going in our favor are things like Moore's Law, the fact that the transistors which do the computations on computers are getting much, much smaller, much, much cheaper, and produced in much greater volumes than before. Moore's Law is about the number of transistors that you can fit in the same size doubling every 18 to 24 months. So obviously if something doubles every 1 to 2 years, then over the course of a decade it can get two orders of magnitude quicker, and that is the situation from pretty much the 1930s up until the early 2000s. We also have the advent of parallel computing, where lots of computers can work together on a single task. We have cheaper hardware. Things have been exponentially cheaper for quite some time now. Whereas a single megabyte of storage would have cost millions of dollars in the 1950s, now terabytes of storage online are almost free. So hardware is getting to the point where the cost per unit is shrinking dramatically, and it's getting much, much cheaper to compute things as well. And also, over the course of decades, companies have developed much better software, and there's a variety of software as well which is used specifically for computational chemistry, which allows these simulations to be run. Okay, so in computational chemistry, these properties that we're simulating, that we're trying to predict, can be pretty much anything under the sun. If you can measure it in an experiment, then in principle, you can compute it. Perhaps there isn't a software package which has been developed to compute certain properties yet, but any property that can be measured can be computed in principle. So these properties include things that are based on energy, things like interaction energies, binding energies, conformational energies, excitation energies, ionization energies, anything involving the energy of a molecule or a system of molecules, things that involve structure, so like the geometry of a molecule or a system, the location of the atoms, the geometry of a solvation shell, of a crystal structure, or things like dipole moments and polarizabilities of electron clouds, things related to structure. Also have things related to spectra, things like infrared spectra, nuclear magnetic resonance, NMR, microwave, UV-Vis, X-ray. All of these kinds of spectra can be simulated in various ways. And then there are a variety of properties which are emergent out of these or combinations of these, things like bulk thermodynamic data, equilibrium, kinetic rates, those sorts of things. So over the course of the computational chemistry playlist, these are the types of things that we'll discuss and the various models that are used to compute them and what actually goes behind them and how we go about carrying out these simulations.